students. How are you doing? I hope you are fine and safe at home. So, myself, Vishnu, I'm going to give you English for grade 6, unit 1. So here, in unit 1, there are various concepts. So, at first, we are going to learn first three concepts. Okay? The first one is facts and opinions. What's the first one? The first one is facts and opinions. And the second one is active listening. What is the second one? The second one is active listening. And the third one is previewing a text. So, today we are going to learn three concepts in first unit one. The first concept is facts and opinion. The second concept is active listening. And the third concept is previewing a text. So, while reading a text, when we read a book or a newspaper or any other text in our books or in our mobile phones or laptops or anything, what are the three concepts we need to follow when reading a text or a newspaper or any content? We need to follow, first we need to follow the fact and opinions, second one is active listening, third one is previewing a text, facts and opinions. Active listening, previewing a text. So one by one we are going to learn each concept in a wide range of manner. Okay? The first one is facts and opinions. What is mean by fact? What is mean by fact? Fact means the thing, the statement which is already proven. Okay? Already proven and already experienced and already proven by someone. So everyone will accept a fact. For example, the sun rises in the east. See students, you just think whether the sun rises in the east or sun rises in the west. Yeah, the sun will always rise in the east. So everyone will accept a fact because it is already proven. The sun only rises in the east. Okay. If I drop the chalk piece like this, means what will happen? Yeah, the chalk piece will fall down. So what does it mean by this? It's a gravitational force. The attractive force of the earth. So this is a proven one. See? So this is a proven one. So this is known as fact. So when reading a statement, we need to know whether the statement is true or false. If it is true and proven one, it is known as fact. On the other end, opinions. Opinions means opinions differ from person to person. If one person has an opinion in this sense, other one will have the other. See, one student will love maths and other student will love English. That is opinion. Opinion differs from person to person. Opinion is a feeling or emotion which came from our heart. Okay? Everyone has separate opinions. Opinion differs from person to person. It actually depends upon one's interest and one's thinking, thought, feeling, everything. So, a good reader will surely separate facts from opinions while reading a text. So, facts in the sense, fact means it's a true thing, it's a statement, it is already proven by someone, it is accepted by everyone. And opinion is differ from person to person. It depends on a person's internal feeling or emotion, his interest or his interest of subject. So good readers always try to differentiate facts from opinions. So let us see the major difference between facts and opinions. So now we are going to see the major differences between facts and opinions. So, facts are true to everyone and opinions differ from person to person. Can be proven and opinions cannot be proven because it differs from person to person. The opinions depend upon one student's or person's own interest. So, about to give an example for facts and opinions. Just for facts, sun rises in the east because it's a proven thing and for everyone this same. For everyone, the sun rises in the east. The second one is Nagpur is a beautiful city. So Nagpur is a beautiful city in the sense if one loves Nagpur, other will love another city. So it is full and full of personal interest and choice. So it comes under opinion. The next one is same examples. In facts, sun rises in the east. For everyone, the sun will rise in the east. So it is a proven thing. So it comes under facts. The next one is Nagpur is a beautiful city. Nagpur is a place. So someone will love Nagpur, another will own like the place. So it comes under personal choice, that is opinions. The next one is a week has 7 days. Normally every week has 7 days. Everyone will accept, right? Because it is a fact. It won't differ from person to person. And the next one is apples are tasty. If one like apple in the sense, other one will like oranges. So it depends upon the personal choice of the student or any other person. So these are the difference between facts and opinions. Facts and opinion. So once again, I am recalling the first concept, facts and opinion. Facts means it full and full depends upon a true statement. That is already proven one. So while reading a text, we need to differentiate facts and opinions in the text. So facts means it is a true one. It is already proven statement. So no one can change the fact. So mostly the science concepts will come under the facts. And the grammar rules also come under the facts because it is already proven one. So no one can change the facts. So opinion in the sense, opinion differ from person to person. It totally depends upon the interest, the feeling, the emotions of a particular person. It differs from person to person. A good reader surely differentiate fact from opinion. Next, we learn the major difference between facts and opinions. That is, fact, it is a proven one. It is a proven one, and opinion cannot be proven because it changes from person to person. The second point is, fact is true for everyone. It won't differ from person to person, but the concept will differ from person to person. The sun rises in the east, the week has 7 days. And for an opinion, the examples are Nagpur is a beautiful place or beautiful city, or apples are tasty, math is my favorite subject. These are commoner opinions. So now you are clear on the first concept, facts and opinions. So now we are going to move to the second one, that is active listening. Second concept is active listening. What is meant by listening? Yeah, listening means giving time or giving a piece of time to someone to listen what they are telling, to concentrate on what is on others' mind, what they are willing to say to us. So, active listening. To improve our active listening, we need to concentrate. We need to concentrate on the speaker, what the people is saying to us. In a class also, if we need to listen actively, you need to concentrate on teacher's words. What teacher is teaching us, what she is trying to say, what she is trying to show us, what she is trying to make us learn. So, you need to listen actively. So, you need to give your full and full attention to the speaker. If you didn't give your attention or attention, and you see somewhere else and you sit down talking to your friend or someone else's friends, you can't get what other is trying to say to you. So you need to actively listen. So you need to give your attention to the speaker. So, second concept is active listening. Active listening means we need to listen to what others try to communicate with us. We need to give our full and full attention to them. Then only we can understand what they are saying. So, for active listening, we need to follow. We need to give attention to the speaker. That is, someone is speaking. The next one is concentrate. We need to concentrate on them so that we can understand their thoughts. For example, while teacher is teaching in the class, if you didn't give your attention or concentration to the teacher in this sense, whether you will understand the subject? No, you won't understand the subject and you won't understand the concepts. So, you should give your attention and concentration towards the speaker. Not only attention and concentration, the third one is remembering. You should first give attention to the speaker and try to concentrate on what they are saying. And the third one is try to remember what they are saying. You need to remember what they said on that day. Okay, teacher taught likewise. So we need to learn this one. Likewise, you need to remember everything. First, you need to give attention. Second one, concentration. Third one is remembering. See, while you listen actively, you will respect the speaker. It is like respecting the speaker, giving some respect to the speaker. See, in the class, if you talk in between a teacher's class means, what does the teacher feel? She or he will feel that you are not respecting him or her. So, you need to give respect to the speaker and you should give your attention, you should concentrate and you should remember what they said. So, this is known as active listening. To improve your active listening, you need to follow the following 3 steps. Next, we are going to learn 3 steps. 3 very, very simple steps. Okay. So, the 3 steps. First step is you need to listen to them. You need to look at the speaker. You need to always make eye contact with the speaker. So only you can understand everything. So only you can concentrate. So first one is Look at the speaker. If you look at somewhere else, you won't understand anything. So you need to look at the speaker's eyes, or else you need to look at the speaker. Try to make eye contact with the speaker. The second one is listen to the speaker without interrupting them. Don't disturb them while they are speaking or they are conveying something important. Don't interrupt them in their conversation. You need to wait, listen. Then once they finish their speech, you can communicate with them. Don't interrupt in between their speech. Then the third one is restate what the speaker shared. So third one is you need to retell the what the speaker shared to you. That is, the third one is remembering. You need to remember everything and you need to restate that. Okay, if the speaker is saying, hi, hello, I'm fine. How are you? And I am doing very good. I am very happy today. Likewise, the speaker is telling to you means, first you need to look at the speaker. You need to understand what the speaker is telling. You should not interrupt them. And last, you need to recall. Yes, the speaker is telling that she is happy, he is fine, and she is doing very well. First, you need to give full attention to them. Second, you need to concentrate on what they are telling. And then you need to remember. You should not interrupt them in between, so that it will reflect like you are disrespecting them. So you need to give your full attention to the person while someone is communicating to you. So till now, we completed two concepts in Unit 1. The first one is facts and opinions, and the second one is active listening. The first one, facts and opinions, means fact is a thing, it is a true statement, which is already proven, and it is experimented with someone and proven. It won't differ from person to person. Fact is same for everyone. So, for example, the sun rises in the east. So, the next one is opinion. Opinion means it depends upon one person's emotions or feelings or personal interest, personal choice. It differs from person to person. That is, apples are tasty. If someone likes apples, another will like oranges or any other fruits. So, opinions will differ from person to person. The good reader always try to differentiate facts and opinions in the text. Actually, in a text, there will be facts and opinions mingled with each other. We need to differentiate which one is fact, which one is opinion said by someone. So, fact is one. Fact cannot be changed. It won't differ from person to person. Opinion is opinion differ from person to person. It is full and full personal choice. It's not everyone one. It is not same for everyone. So the second thing, the second concept is active listening. Active listening means we need to listen actively to the speaker. Improving our listening skills, first we need to give attention to the speaker. We need to give attention to the speaker and we need to concentrate on what they are saying. If we didn't concentrate on the things, we won't gain or we won't remember anything. So we need to always give attention to the speaker. So if you are giving attention and concentrating to the speaker will feel that you are respecting them, or else they will feel disrespectful and the total communication becomes useless. So first we need to give attention to them, and we need to give full attention to them, and we need to concentrate on what they are telling. And third one, we need to remember the thing what they said. If you won't remember, in the sense there's a lack of concentration. So you need to concentrate well and remember well. That is the sign of active listening and good communication. So here also three steps are there to improve your listening skills. The first one is look at the speaker. So you need to look at the speaker. You need to make eye contact with the speaker. You should not see somewhere else where someone is standing. an important thing to you. So you need to look at the speaker and make eye contact with them. The second one is, don't interrupt the speaker. You should not interrupt them. You should not stop them, or you should not talk in between them. If you interrupt them, means the communication will break and they can't communicate. They can't tell you what they feel. So you should not interrupt the speaker while they are telling something to you. The third one is, you need to restate what they share. Restate in the sense, you need to remember and you need to restate in your mind. Oh, this or this person tell this one to me. Yeah, I remember this. Likewise, you need to restate. If you won't remember anything, or if you won't concentrate, means you can't restate the statement, and the whole conversation become a total block conversation, or it will be a useless one. So first, you need to look at the speaker. You need to give eye contact with the speaker. And second one is, you should not interrupt the speaker. You should not disturb the speaker while they are conveying something. Or second, the third one is a restate. You need to restate in your mind that what you understand about the conversation. So this is the second concept, active listening. Now we are going to move to the third concept, that is previewing the text. Previewing a text. Previewing a text means look into the text before reading the text clearly. So before reading the text clearly, elaborately, you should look for some clues or information or ideas in the text. So this is known as previewing the text. Previewing the text makes you to understand the text very, very easier. So first, we need to follow some sort of steps. So there are 5 steps given for you. These 5 steps will help you to improve your previewing experience. Previewing the text means getting idea. Previewing a text in the sense, we can get idea before reading. We can recall. We can understand the text. Previewing the text in the sense, we will get idea before reading, we can understand and we can recall what we learned, and we can understand the text very easily. There are 5 steps to learn this one, 5 steps to improve your previewing experience. So next we are going to deal with the 5 steps, okay? The next upcoming concepts we can see in our next class. I hope you all understand the concepts. So happy to see you. Thank you. You can see in the next class. There are various steps to preview a text. So there are 5 steps given for you to preview a text. So one by one we are going to learn what are the things. Okay. The first step is, first you need to read the title. Important thing is, before reading a text or a lesson or a poem, you need to read the title of the text. Okay, first you need to read the title of the text, and you will be very conscious about the title. Given 5 steps for you. One by one we will learn the steps. The first step is, you need to read the title. You need to read the title. What is meant by title? Title is the heading given for the text. Okay. The title is a heading given for the text. See, we learned three concepts. Each concept have each is title. Okay. So likewise, every lesson have titles, every poem have titles, and every text have appropriate titles. So first we need to read the title clearly. On reading the title, we came to know that okay, whether we know the topic or not, whether we can learn some information about that or not. So we can understand whether we know the topic or else. So first we need to read the title. The second one is before reading the text clearly, first we need to check whether it have any title. Surely the text will have a title. So first you read the title and you remember the title in your mind. The second one is look at the pictures, if any. So if in some text there will be pictures, in some other text there won't be any pictures. If there is any pictures, you need to look at the pictures. And you need to observe the pictures, whether the picture is explaining something, whether the picture is giving any clue, whether the picture is telling any story. Likewise, you need to look at the pictures. If the picture is there in the sense, you need to look at the pictures. The third one is you need to give close attention. Closely you need to watch whether any subtitles is given. Whether any subtitles is given or any words are in black or bold letters. Second one is we need to look at the pictures. If any picture is given, we need to look at the and we need to gather information from the picture. So third one is subtitles and words. So first third one is we need to check whether any subtitle is given in the text or any type of clues, that is any words are given in black or bold letters, whether anything is underlined. Likewise, you need to give close attention to the clues in the text. So the fourth step is we need to read the few lines. Read the few lines below the subtitles. So the third step, you will search for subtitles. So in the fourth step, you need to read certain one or two or three or four lines below the subtitles. You need to check your previous knowledge about the topic. So next one is you need to ask yourself questions. You need to ask yourself whether you understand the text by previewing the text or not, whether you know the topic or not, whether you can remember everything you see or not. Likewise, you need to ask yourself. These are the five steps for previewing a text. So the first one is you need to read the title. You need to read the title at the starting, so you can find what the text is about. The second one is you need to look at the pictures. You need to search for the pictures if a picture is given, or else No problem. So you need to look for the pictures, whether a picture is given, whether the picture is telling anything, whether the picture is conveying any story or information to the readers. So look at the pictures in any. Next one, you need to search for clues. You need to pay close attention to the subtitles. If the subtitles is given, you need to check for the subtitles and words. If any words is given in black or bold letters, or any clues are given, or any underlined words are there, so you need to pay close attention to these clues. The fourth one is, you need to read few lines under the subtitles. If subtitle is given, surely there will be something else under the below the subtitles. So first read 1, 2, or 3, or 4 lines below the subtitles and try to understand. And the fifth last step is ask yourself. You need to question yourself. You need to question yourself whether you understand the text, whether you remember anything from the text. What is the text? What is the meaning of the text or meaning of the title? Whether you have any previous knowledge or previous information regarding the text. Likewise, you need to recall everything. This is the 5 major steps for previewing the text. So today we learned 3 concepts. Okay, unit 1, 3 concepts. The first one is facts and opinions. The second one is active listening. The third one is previewing the text. Facts and opinions. So facts in the sense, fact is a true statement. It won't differ from person to person. So opinion means differ from person to person. One example for fact is the sun rises in the east. Then one example for opinion is apples are tasty. Because the opinion differs from person to person. Our second topic is active listening. Active listening means we need to listen actively to the speaker to gain information. Here we need to follow attention. We need to give attention to the speaker. Second, we need to concentrate on the speaker. Third, we need to remember what they said. So here also we learned 3 steps. First, 3 steps to improve active listening. The first one is we need to give attention. We need to give, we need to look at the speakers. Okay, always look at the speaker. So we need to give eye contact to the speaker. Eye contact to the speaker. The second one is we won't interrupt the speaker. While someone is speaking something to us, we should not interrupt them by saying anything or doing any sort of things. So we need to listen carefully and we should not interrupt the speaker while they are conveying an information. Next one is we need to restate. We need to remember and rethink their opinion. Okay. First we need to look at the speaker. We need to be eye contact with the speaker. And next one is we shouldn't interrupt the speaker. Third one is we need to rethink what the speaker said. If you remember what the speaker said in a sense, you are concentrated very well and you are an active listener. If you shouldn't remember anything means there is no concentration for you. You should improve your concentration. So the third concept is previewing a text. Previewing the text means before reading a text, we try to gain some idea about the text before reading it completely. So here we need to find the pictures or clues or anything else, titles, subtitles, everything to gather information about the text before reading it properly. So here also there are 5 steps which helps you to improve your reading, text reading, improve your previewing the text experience. So the first one is you should read the title. First, find the title and read the title and try to understand the title. The second one is look for the pictures. Try to look for the pictures. If picture is given, you need to look for a picture. Or else, it's not a problem. So, look at the pictures and try to understand whether the picture is telling any story or information to you. So, this is the second step. Third step, pay close attention. You need to observe clearly to see whether any subtitles are given. Whether any subtitles are there or any words are in black letters or any words are in black color bold letters or any words are underlined. or any words are in italic format. So likewise, you need to pay close attention. This is the third step. The fourth step is you need to read few lines below the subtitles. Below the subtitles, there will be some lines. So you try to read on 3 or 4 lines to understand the text. So this is the third step. The fourth one is ask yourself, question yourself. You should question yourself to get the answer. If you are clear with the answers, then everything is okay, that you are good enough to understand the text. Or else you need to preview once again. First ask yourself what you read from the text, what you have seen in the text, what's the picture in the text, what does the picture defines to you, what is the title, whether you know the title before, whether you have any previous knowledge about the title. Likewise, you just ask yourself, question yourself. If the answer is positive, then it is okay that you have previewed the text very well. If you can't preview the text very well, once again try from the first step. So you can get a positive result. So today we completed 3 concepts, children. So in the next class, we can deal the further coming concepts. So I hope you understand the concepts very well. So thank you, students. We can see in the next class.